National Eucalyptus Day. What a wonderful thing to have. Two facts, one of which I'm sure that you are aware, and that is the floral emblem of Tasmania is the Tasmanian blue gum. The other is the number of unique eucalypts that exist in this state. A man who knows his eucalypts is Chris Lang, the Royal Tasmanian Botanical Gardens Curator of Tas Flora, and was celebrating earlier today with a bit of a walk through the gardens, looking at some of the special eucalypt species that are there. Chris, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Louise. How are you?
I'm well. What a lovely job you have to be able to wander the gardens and look at trees and flowers all day.
It's not too bad. No, I can't complain. It's a nice environment in which to work.
It certainly is. I like the idea of National Eucalyptus Day. I'd never heard of it before, and I hadn't realised, apart from knowing, of course, about the blue gum as our state emblem, floral emblem, that there were so many eucalypts that are unique to this state. But it seems there's more than a few.
Yeah, look, there's 18 that are endemic to the state, meaning that they occur nowhere else apart from Tasmania. And, you know, some pretty special yews as well, you know, in that number.
Mm.
But we've got around about, you know, there's 30 species altogether that occur naturally in Tassie. You know, it's not an incredibly diverse eucalypt flora that we have here, but we have some, you know, really interesting species.
Now, forgive the naivety of the question, but is a eucalypt always a gum tree, and is a gum tree always a eucalypt?
Well, eucalyptus, of course, is the, you know, is the genus, so that's kind of the scientific name. And a gum tree, you know, gum tree so named because of the sap, the keno, I guess is the technical term, that is found in eucalypts that you sort of see when the trees are injured as a result of mechanical injury. Eucalyptus, gum tree, whatever you want.
They're marvellous things right around the nation, aren't they? From the red gums, the snow gums, the white gums, all the different things. And they seem so attuned to their environment. Are they, Chris?
Oh, they are. You know, they are. And they're incredibly adaptable. I mean, you know, it's a genus that dominates Australia's tree flora. You know, there's over 800 species in Australia. There's a few that occur outside the country. And they occur in all sorts of environments. You know, in Tasmania, we see them in the wettest places, the driest parts of the state, low-altitude coastal areas, right up to, you know, the highest alpine areas.
Mm.
You know, we've got a real tough nut, Eucalyptus vernicosa. That is incredibly cold tolerant and puts up with the wild conditions that it's exposed to, you know, at sort of 1,300 or so metres. So, you know, we've got the tallest euc as well. We've got Eucalyptus regnans, which is the tallest flowering plant in the world. So, you know, that's not an endemic. That also occurs in Victoria, but it's a pretty special species.
It is, isn't it? And this is where I think that the Californian redwood comes in. It's the tallest tree, but we've got the flowering tree claiming
that's the height. Well, that's right. The Sequoia sempervirens is a gymnosperm, so that's a conifer.
Mm.
This is an angiosperm, so it's a flowering plant. And, you know, it reaches, I think, the tallest specimen is one called Centurion in the Southern Forest, and it's around about 99.8 or so metres now.
Mm. Tell me about the Risdon peppermint. I mean, there it is just across the river, and I'd never heard of it.
The Risdon peppermint, yeah. Well, that's one of seven rare and threatened eucalypt species. And, yeah, it's right on our doorstep. It's on the eastern shore, sort of from areas behind, in the hills behind Tranmere, Meon Rains there, and right through to sort of smatterings of populations up near Mangalore.
Mm.
But it's an incredible tree in that it, you know, it thrives in the driest locations, northwest facing, very dry mudstone, incredibly harsh environments. It's not a big tree. It's about 3 to 8 metres tall, very attractive, beautiful bark, and it, you know, has that lovely sort of glaucous appearance. You can pick it out, actually, you know, as you travel to the Hobart, to the airport or back from Hobart, you can see it in the hills there. It's that sort of really glaucous, you know, silvery grey kind of foliage eucalypt. It's through the hills.
My guest, Chris Lang from the Royal Tasmanian Botanical Gardens. Tell me about some of the things that eucalypts do. They're remarkable in their bid to survive, to thrive and to reproduce. Everything from the way the leaves hang to the way they use water. They're remarkable, aren't they?
Oh, they are. Yeah, they're incredibly resourceful in that regard. I mean, one of the really interesting aspects of eucalypts and their ability to sort of resurrect is, following a fire event. They're quite amazing. They have special buds beneath the bark called epicormic buds. That when they're exposed to fire, and all the foliage, the exposed foliage is taken out. These epicormic buds post fire, they sprout and emerge, and the tree continues. And there's a lignature at the very base of the eucalypts, not all of them, but that can regenerate after fire as well. Something like Eucalyptus regnans doesn't produce a lignature, and I think it's pretty short in epicormic buds, so it relies on a massive seed load to regenerate and, to really, swamp those sort of insects that would otherwise eat the seed. they're incredible. They're incredible plants.
They are, and I have to finish on the smell because it's such a special thing, isn't it? Particularly if there's a bit of moisture in the air, is to smell those trees. You couldn't be anywhere else but, I think, somewhere in Australia.
It's superb, isn't it? I know as we actually approached the eucalyptus rhizdonii on the walk today, it was that sort of, fairly damp atmosphere, and the smell was quite overwhelming, and it's a gorgeous smell. I love it. Yeah.
I've conjured it in my mind as we speak. Chris, great to talk to you, and thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.